So before we move forward, I just wanted to understand the kind of people we have. So would like to understand how many of you guys already have a startup. If you can just say a startup in the comment section, I will get a gauge of it. So I can see Prafulla has a startup, Aditya also has a startup, Shirisha. Yes, I see a lot of startup founders out here. And that is exactly what we are here to help you with. Rohit, right? Okay, nobody who wanted to do a startup, if you are willing to start up or in future, about, so you just mentioned about to start up. Okay. So Srinivas says, okay, he's about to start up, currently is in stealth mode. That's totally fine. Great. So without taking much of your time, we have a sense of what kind of startups we have. I would like to introduce you to our first session, wherein we have the founder of Pune Eat Outs, Anirudh Patil. So Anirudh has worked in corporate for more than 11 years before he started to decide to jump into this food industry and make a mark. So right now, Pune Eat Out is Pune's number one Facebook group supporting local restaurants. And so he and Pune Eat Out is the friends of local restaurants. So far he has done or supported more than 150,000 people, right, through his network and association. So to help understand more and help you learn how you can grow your startup like Pune Eat Outs has done, I would like to welcome Anirudh here. Welcome, Anirudh.
Yeah, Abhishek, thanks a lot for having me here. I hope you guys can hear me clearly. I mean, is the sound clear?
It is very clear, Anirudh.
Fantastic, fantastic. So, hi everyone, good morning once again. And very good to know about Head Start. And without, again, as we said, spending much time on the formalities, we'll strictly or quickly jump on to what I have to share. So we'll just take a few seconds. Of course, before I started Pune Eat Out, rather Pune Eat Out was happening on the sides. Before I started to take it up full time, I did work almost 11 years in corporate by my education. I have a degree of engineering to show. I done my MBA from SP Jain. I worked in multiple countries all over India as well. And here we are today talking about local businesses. We'll largely talk about you, your customer, and your hyper local business. It's a and I'm gonna touch based upon some basics of things. Basics, because trust me, I still do not see a lot of things followed by a lot of business, although we know them. So the interesting part about most of the startups, most of the small businesses, or anybody who's into it as a self-driven person, we focus so much on operation, we focus so much on getting our businesses up and running that even the thing that we know, we don't really focus on. So what do I mean by that? We'll definitely see in the next few minutes. In the process, if you think I'm going too fast or too slow, you want me to take a halt and repeat something, please comment and we'll try to work accordingly. So before we start, of course, thanks to this pandemic and I would say even through some political or other reasons, vocal for local kind of became a catchphrase, right? I mean, there came a time that we almost put a nationalized aspect to it as well. Okay, don't buy from this our neighbor, don't buy from China, don't buy from anywhere else. Apart from everything, what is local or hyper local to you? I think we need to talk about your definition. Is local something that I get within my 3 kilometers? Is Kotsur local to me? Is Pune CAM local to me? Is Pune local to me? Is Pune district local to me? Or Maharashtra is local to me? Or maybe India is local to me? I believe all of us kind of struggle with this definition. And honestly, I don't have a definition for this. Let's assume you are a trader and you are buying something from say Rajasthan and selling it in Pune. So do I not call you local? Something we can ponder upon, right? So the best way I believe what local or hyper local is, it's something that okay, when all things are available to you, what choice do you make? How to grow business or how to take it ahead? What channels to choose? I think most of the businesses when you spend more time thinking before starting a business, lesser efforts and time you require executing your plans. So you need to ask yourself, why are we into it? Is it my need because I don't have an earning source? Is it my liking? Or I'm jumping onto it because I see an opportunity? Or maybe a combination of all the three. In my experience, if you have a choice of starting businesses or if you can, it always helps to like something, then start. The opportunities, as we discussed, the online opportunities that are available to you, they are available to everybody else as well. So we have to really, really find the differentiators. When you go, you have to know the product or service you are offering, what particular segment it operates, what kind of budgets you want to put into for your establishment or execution or marketing as a business as a whole. And that will always give you a good mix of online and offline positioning, I would say, that you would want to do. Because ultimately, whatever you offer, even the presence or the modus operandi would be online, you will be having touch points that you encounter offline as well. Even if for a complete online service, it does affect somebody's life in the real world. So great to be online, but I think let's be real that all the positivity, all the things that glitter at the start, you have to sustain those. I think we're talking about pandemic, business in pandemic. The lockdowns changed a lot of things for all of us, personally, professionally, business-wise. And I'm sure a lot of startups and businesses are faced with a dilemma because as we noticed, we are on the same grounds, right? We have to know as a hyper-local entity that even to start, we are not bigger. The way you can make a mark is by being better at something. Then what is that better? You have to figure out. You may not be better with your technology. You may not be better with your product. But there must be an aspect that nobody really beats you in. Ultimately, that's what we call USP, right? What is an USP? When somebody tells me that this product is my USP, have you thought of it? What exactly is the meaning of USP? How simply you can define it? I'll tell you how I define it. USP is something that at particular segment, nobody does that thing better than me. See, relationships are like habits. Till something goes wrong, we don't really change those. To prove my point, ask yourself, when was the last time you changed your milk supplier and your newspaper supplier? You don't change those. I think most of you are faced with challenges. How do you want to deal with your technology? You want to build it, you want to buy it, and the recent fascination, subscribe to one. See, building IT was always there. You could always buy ready stuff. What I mean by build is, you build something from scratch. You build a system for yourself. Or you could buy existing one from vendors. Now, there is an aspect where you can subscribe to it. There are local players, there are Shopify's of the world, there are StoryPo of the world, and many more. You can subscribe to it, check it out. What works for you, you need to evaluate that. You need to figure it out. If you can't really take a decision, there are consultants available, people you know. I mean, I'm not trying to sell it here, but there are people, me, or there are people like Gully Boy, or I'm sure there are many more in the market who will help you with this. Again, it depends on your product. It depends on your segment. It depends on your budgets, as we discussed in previous slides. This choice is very important. Subscribe makes actually a very interesting choice because that gives you time till you build or till you decide to buy something. It gets you online quickly. Most people are marketing it out online, right? On social media, on websites, through Google ads, through Facebook ads. So when all of us do same thing, what happens? We lose the advantage, right? So everybody doing the same thing kind of becomes a qualification criteria and doesn't really give you any advantage. Out of 100 businesses, when 5 businesses went online and they approached a particular channel, those 5 got advantage. But you can definitely decide what you want to do on those channels. So one of the cheapest channels you get is social media. When I say social media, I don't only mean Facebook, Instagram. I also mean the likes of WhatsApp or the word of mouth. Social media is not only online. Social is also offline. When you meet people, when they talk about you. I believe what you're doing right now, communities like Head Start, this is social media as well. So when you do this marketing bit, please decide what are you going to do on your own brand pages? What are you going to do in your paid ads? What do you plan to do with online community like Puneet Outs or any other that you are a part of? What is the common mistake I think that every business does, but the most businesses do? We are using the same content and blasting it all over. It goes on WhatsApp, it goes in communities, it goes on pages. Well, who want to create content for every platform, right? We don't want to. Big mistake, I would say. The reviews play a lot of role onto it. Every business get good word of my mouth. Every business gets some flack sometimes. Positive reviews, I won't talk much. When somebody tells you you're doing well, it means you're doing well. Continue or just grow. Negative reviews, honestly, there's nothing like a negative review to me. What is a negative review? Negative review is equal to anger plus feedback. I haven't seen anything more than that. You have to take away the anger, the words out of it, and see if there is a feedback for you. If there's a feedback, great, work on it. If you think there is no feedback, just anger, ignore it, move on, maybe just specify the customer. So what is a sale to you? Is it a goal or is it an outcome? Again, a classic example, guys, this is very much a personal of me. I never really read it anywhere. So I ask, say, Abhishek or Harshvardhan, sir, what is your goal? And Harshvardhan will come and maybe tell me that, so my goal is to buy a Ferrari or maybe something else. But guys, is it really a goal? I would like to believe it's an outcome. Perhaps the goal is to grow your business, do good products, give good service, have a expansion plan, make a lot of money, and maybe the Ferrari will happen. Okay, forget Ferrari. Maybe Hyundai will happen. Same thing, right? I mean, you ask, what do you want to do in 2021? Somebody tells me, I want to lose 20 kgs. So that can't be the goal. That's an outcome. That's an outcome of me following your diet or going to gym every day. Apply this principle to all your businesses, all your activities. Whatever you want to do, is that a goal or an outcome? And I believe you'll get most answers. So sale for me is an outcome of having a good product, doing good marketing, reaching out to people, doing everything that you can. It's not really a goal the way I look at it.
Great. So guys, I thank Anirudh for his insights and about how he must have grown Pune Eat Outs to this extent. So next session, what we have is our amazing partnership with Kalibai, right? And Anirudh spoke about the importance of reaching out to the customers and having their intrinsic details, like their birthdays, right? And so the challenge for us as an entrepreneurs are, we are always busy operationally, right? And we have our businesses to run. We have to look into the cash book, cash flows, and we do not have enough time to market ourselves and to reach out to our customers. Hence, we have partnered with Kalibai, whose sole motto is to help local businesses grow. They have a zero commission model, zero setup fee model, wherein you sell your stuff, but they don't charge you on commissions, right?